I like it, you all of my... All right, coming up next is the UFC light heavyweight division collision. This guy has truly made the takedown a thing of beauty in mixed martial arts. With respect to yourself and George St. Pierre and the truly great takedown artists, this guy's closing the gap and entering that company in the eyes of many.
Oh, absolutely, because he's done such a great job of timing takedowns. I haven't seen anyone so good at slipping a jab into a takedown since George St. Pierre.
Right.
He does a phenomenal job of getting from step one to step two before his opponent even realizes, now he's in on my leg. And if they do get their hips back, immediately he's up into a foot sweep, or a headlock, or an inside trip. It's just so many different ways for him to get you to the floor that he will throw every single one at you every single time.
And a lot of fighters talk about that wrestling maintenance and how hard it is, right, over the course of a career to continue to drill those things. He talks a lot about that, and that's why he's continued to realize success here in the UFC. Well, pretty much every time out in the UFC, DC, this man has put on a striking clinic, and that is his methodology coming in here tonight. He'll try to keep the fight on the feet.
And that's why we tune in, right? That's why we tune in. We tune in to see guys that are dynamic. We tune in for the speed. We tune in for the knowledge of the striking game, the ability to set traps, the ability to find the jab, the ability to find the right hand, the right kick, the left kick, the knees, the elbows. He truly uses every weapon that he has in his arsenal to try and finish his opponent. You make one mistake, night's over. You cannot make mistakes against a guy that has the striking acumen of this guy right here.
And the jab is not as underutilized a weapon as it was in MMA, say, 5 or 7 years ago, but he's got as good a jab as anyone in the business, and that is where all of his striking flows off of. We'll see how it goes for him in this matchup tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 16 wins, 7 losses. He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Santa Cruz, California, Luke Rockhold. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 14 wins, no losses. He stands 5'11" tall, weighing in at 195 pounds. Fighting out of Richmond, Virginia, Dubois.
And when the action begins, the referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean has drawn the assignment here.
Ready.
All right, ready to go with round one. Shades of Vitor Belfort circa 2013 for this young man.
Oh! Huge right hand!
Crazy accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And for the opponent, you got to intelligently defend or the referee's going to stop
him. You got to defend. You can see him now start to gain posture and the intensity at which he's doing these ground strikes. Because he knows that he can get the finish.
Back to the feet now. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the count.
Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. Nice connection with a punch there. It's hard to recall a time in the past that his boxing was this sharp.
He's never looked this good.
And that left hook landed on the button.
What a fantastic wrestler. Great takedown.
Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground tonight.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent.
What an offering up over the top. This fight's going to be over this season.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high when his opponent thought he was going low, and now he's got him hurt very badly. He went high on that one.
Oh! He's out!
Yo! Wow! That was nasty! What a fight!
Yeah, that right there. sure is a high-level knockout, ladies and gentlemen. Crowd absolutely loving it. Just a perfect shot to end the fight. Landed flush. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming. So a huge, huge win for that young fighter here tonight. Oh, we'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're going to find that nasty head kick somewhere in this highlight rip. Just an incredible result for him here tonight.
A very nice head kick to finish the fight. But don't ignore all the work he did with his hands. And give credit to the opponent. The opponent was in there every step of the way. And in order to get a fight of the night like you got tonight, both guys have to be willing to participate.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean's called the stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 40 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Dubois!
So the celebration is on with him and his team, and rightfully so. A monumental result tonight as he gets the win by knockout.
He spoke it into existence. He said over and over to anyone that'll listen, I am going to knock this man out. He did it in an even more impressive fashion than he ever could have imagined.